this is my Tales of Wind guide on the best Glory Heart rewards to pick and the overall rating on them. So for Glittering Guardian Mermaid Princess, I would not recommend this guardian over the other Glittering Guardians due to the fact that it gives penetration and heavy. For heavy, it's unusable due to the Venus Pro giving more than most general people's heavy, and it would still be zero even with this 3%. And penetration is useless because of that heavy being useless. And penetration counters heavy. Shining Moonset is one of the best PvE glove PvP weapon cards, if not the best. It is 50% stronger than Shining Ramunda, but has no shield, so it might be weaker than Ramunda. I generally prefer Shining Ramunda over Shining Moonset due to it not having shields and Shining Ramunda just having better utility than Shining Moonset in PvP. And it also gives Amphrite its side effect, which makes Amphrite and Shining Ramunda stronger. Amphrite is the best glove card in PvP and one of the best in PvE. I'll talk about the best glove cards in PvE on another video. It gives 70% max HP on level 8 Shining Amphrite, and it also breaks you out of control effects, which can get you killed in PvP. Sparrow is not a top priority because it is just a PvE transformation, but it's outdated by all the shining cards in PvE, which gives more damage and more utility. Rallying has one of the largest range in the game. It shoots fireballs in front, but it is outdated by Shining Amphrite in PvP, and the damage is weaker than Thor in PvP and also weaker than Shining Amphrite, so this it won't be a good pick unless you just want the tenacity. Lisa is still one of the best headwear cards in the game, even with all the shinings, because it gives so much crit damage and damage to high HP. Anubis is one of the best PvP transformations because it can revive your teammates, and it can revive up to two teammates because it lasts 20 seconds and the skill cooldown is only 10 seconds long. Glittering Battle Angel has the best active effect out of any guardian because it stuns and it gives crit damage, and it also makes itself invulnerable when it resurrects, so it pairs really well when you have a high mutate. Red Guardian Imperial Cat Zhao is a attack guardian. It has attack percent on the skill, which is why I would get this if your server does not have any shinings out yet. Because even if it gets out there, you could dismantle it for the book. Godly Cynthia is outdated. I would not recommend you to get this transformation card because it's only for control effects. Even as a transformation, it does very low damage. Ayla is power crept in every way by Shining Amphrite. I would not recommend it as it has no uses anymore due to being outdated by Amphrite. Storm Raccoon is like the transformation Natsu but more tankier, so it's if not the top three transformation picks in PvP because it could demount and basically make people dance and increase your team damage and survivability. Jhaya is outdated in every way by Lisa, and It is not recommended because it has no tenacity despite being a tier 4 card. Shining Astria, Red Guardian Astria is a red guardian with attack. And I would pick this if your server is still new because it can hold you over and it won't get outdated as fast. Muramasa, I would not pick this, even though it used to be the best transformation, it's outdated. Godly Shishni, you could get this from Gold Chest. I would not pick this. You could get free to play. Core, never pick this. It's useless as a headwear card. It's useless. Can't state this how many times. It's just useless. Dory, if your server just began, this would be your top pick. Pick this over everything else, but it is outdated now, but it's very strong still. Maybe like in the top 10 out of all glove cards. But you could exchange it on a very low level so it will hold you for a very long time. And that is my review on every single Glory Heart reward. Let me know in the comments what other things would you like me to review. See you next time.